Good morning. It's day two of my LA 12 trip.
John's adventure vlog.
A lot of what happened yesterday wasn't filmed or documented because I was too busy having fun. That's mainly why I come in like a day early, because they still have work Thursday and Friday, but just having a few hours with them Thursday and Friday nights is worth the trip to come in a little early. I have one day left with the Mustang rental, so today I'm going to take it down to the LAX area again and hopefully try to check out the YouTube creator space. I wanted to get the audio of this Mustang starting up. It's tremendous. Listen to this. I have the GoPro mounted to the front of the Mustang for this trip. Unfortunately, as I feared, you can't just walk up to the YouTube creator space and get in. So you're supposed to go online and make an appointment. Unfortunately, you can't make appointments online, so basically no one can enter this space unless they work there or they have a specific pre-approved production cleared to shoot and film inside. And I don't. I just wanted to walk around and check the place out for a few minutes. But that was a big bust, so I'm kind of disappointed.
All right, so I've come to some park near the airport as I'm waiting for Ezra to pick me up so we can drop off the Mustang, because I don't want to rent it for any more days than I have to. And in the meantime, I'm just hanging out and I got some time to kill. I'm at this park, and I'm going to look for some geocaches, and I have my app opened up here. So I'm headed towards Chobolo's HP Series number 4 Goblet of Fire. Difficulty 1 of 5.
I'm within 10 meters. It's probably in this tree. They said it was under the 16th tree. I'm going to count from here. 15, 16, and 3/4. So it's under these two trees. The hint also said I need to look up, and I'm going to need my flashlight for this.
Oh, there it is.
Over here, next to the fence. Look at this.
All right, so I got the thing here. Just got hit by a baseball. There's a live game going on next to me. That sort of thing happens, you know? I don't know what the fuck this is. What is this? It's like a little goblet. That's right. It's the goblet of, that's the name of the cache. Of course. It all makes sense now. So I can sign the logbook. Congratulations, you found it. Take an item, leave an item. Oh, this guy just put a receipt in here. That's pretty lame. And it's really well camouflaged because the guy like did some fucking arts and crafts hour and put some actual tree branches stuck to the side of it. So that's pretty cool.
That's all there is. It's trash that I found. Give me this. Let me just have it, okay?
You know, it's definitely not lost on me that I was basically just creeping around a bush with a camera while a whole bunch of little kids practiced Little League right next to me. But I can assure you, I'm an honest person. I'm not a creeper pedophile. And if I was, I certainly wouldn't be talking about it on the internet, now would I? You gotta think with your brain. All the pedophiles out there, that's a tip. Word of advice. All right, I got time to find some more caches. And according to the map, there's one at the very corner of this park. We're going for number 2.
So across the street from this park is this deja vu psychic.
So does that mean she can only predict the future if it's happened already? All right, now that I've reached the intersection of who gives a fuck and shit-stained boulevard, the GPS is telling me it's about 20 meters over this way. These are always the geocaches that intrigue me the most, the ones that are hidden in, like, in plain sight, 5 feet from a major roadway. It said a pair of jovial dudes. Do you think it's this street sign that has a couple of wavy lines on it? Maybe it's these funny-looking mushrooms.
The geocache is definitely right here.
I feel like I'm looking for the fucking hidden immunity idol on Survivor right now. And I have a bunch of people in traffic watching me do it.
Who is this?
See it right there?
Yes.
Mission accomplished. Look, look, I found it. This one's tricky. The cars are right next to these little mushroom guys.
So we have an end to our Mustang chapter, but Ezra's out front, and a new chapter awaits. But first, a trip to Fry's.
I'm a little disappointed because this Fry's doesn't appear to have a theme.
It doesn't have a UFO coming out of the front.
Well, that's for sure, but they all have a different theme, like Vegas is gambling.
Maybe the theme is pirates.
It's in like
maybe it's gay pirates. The theme of this Fry's is gay pirates.
No, it's not. You don't even, oh, it's like tiki theme.
Oh, see, so close.
Or I guess that is pretty close to gay pirates.
I love this place. Nerd heaven.
This is where you get baptized into nerddom.
I feel like I'm in a high-rent Chinese restaurant. This is an electronics store. It looks like I'm in Donald Trump's atrium or something. Like, what
I
are we?
I build myself a computer. I've got an old G5, and it's worn out. It's welcome. I want this one. Looks like a jet engine.
You buckle it.
You got handles on the top, which I do like. It won't break, which is nice.
Yeah, I don't want to accidentally blow up.
I want to get a case that has the two key ignitions on either side. You have to turn them at the same time, like a launch code. It's so unnecessary to have a heat sink in the shape of a cannon.
It's America. Everything's got to look like a gun.
The Shrine of the Silver Monkey.
We went through a lot of the key components, picked out the ones Ezra probably should buy online, because that's where it's actually cheaper. We found like a pretty good build for him that should fly through some good HD video for about $1,200 or so.
So we're having some dinner. It's delicious, by the way. And we're brainstorming for ideas we could come up with for a video we could shoot in the Arizona desert tomorrow night.
Joe Colasano, as a cowboy, sits in the center of town and masturbates. Danny Zach pulls up in a red Honda Fit and gets out and says, "Sir, that's inappropriate." And you say,
"I said, times are tough. I need to get some pleasure while I can."
And then Danny says, "You know what? I respect that." Gets in the car and drives away. Boston Johnny comes out and sings the national anthem.
All right.
And then we'll all join in. "Oh, thank you, see." And then we'll do the Harlem Shake.
Unfortunately, that does it for this episode of John's Adventure Vlog, but stay tuned for my continuing adventures from Southern California. In the next video, we go on a road trip in the desert, do some gambling at a casino, and visit the most disgusting place on earth known as the Salton Sea. As always, thank you for watching and listening. My name is Jonathan Paula, and I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.